What's up, beautiful entrepreneurs? Now, micellar water is a great product that you may not think to have on your product list, but you definitely should. This is a really cheap and easy product to make, and it doesn't only help with removing makeup, but it also helps to remove any impurities on your skin. This is a really great ingredient that only costs less than $2 to make, comparably to the actual product itself, which can run you upwards to $6. Now, let's not waste any more time. Let's get right into this formula. Now, I'm not the only one I know that thought that the micellar water and toners were pretty much the same thing, but they are very different and they're used for different purposes. Now, when it comes to using your toners as a way to remove makeup or remove any debris off of your face, but when it comes to micellar water, this is going to have small concentrates of soap that are actually in the product that actually helps to cleanse your skin. So it's not just removing any of the products like when you're using witch hazel, but it's also going to help to cleanse your skin as well and really help to remove any debris that you have on your face. You can use micellar water and not rinse off your face afterwards, or you can also wash it off, but a lot of times when you use micellar water, you can just use it to wipe off your face after you've already used a cleanser, and you just use that afterwards and then apply your moisturizer. Now, when it comes to actually making micellar water, this is going to be a really simple and easy formula. It's going to mainly be water. So we're going to start off strong with our distilled water, and this is going to be at 94%. And we're just going to add this. Then we're going to add in glycerin. Now, glycerin is going to help to retain moisture to your skin. It's going to help draw out moisture from the air and bring it to your skin to really help to keep you moisturized and add more moisture to the product. Now, we're only going to add this in at 2%. You want to really be careful with glycerin because this can make the product more sticky. So if you do add more percents to it, you may notice that it could cause the product to be a little bit stickier because you don't want a tacky feel for this product. This is something that you want to be able to wipe on your face and it not to leave really any residue. So you don't want to add in too much glycerin. Now, when it comes to the cleanser of this product, you're going to be adding in cocamidophil butane. Now, this is going to be your surfactant that's going to help add in the cleansing aspect of this product. Now, we're only adding this in at 3% because it's a really small amount. You don't really need a lot because you're going to be using a cleanser before you use this product, but this is also just to help to get rid of any additional dirt that may be on your skin. So you're only going to be using very small amount. So this is just going to be in at 3% of the formula. Now, when it comes to the surfactants that you add into your micellar water, you just want to be careful with which one that you do use. Now, I did try and add in polysorbate 80 into the micellar water and it actually just clumped up. So this is not going to be water soluble. So you just want to make sure that you know which one that you are using just to make sure that it actually will mix in to your water product. Now for the additives that are really going to help boost up this micellar water. First, we're going to be adding in cucumber extract. Now, cucumber extract is a really great ingredient because it really helps with any anti-inflammatory or antibacterial issues that you may have, and it really helps to smooth out your skin, really helps with any inflammation, brightening up your skin as well. It contains a lot of vitamin A, C, and B, so it really helps to firm your skin and really help to aid in having more smooth, supple, youthful skin. So cucumber extract is a really great one to add. Now we're only going to be adding this in at 1%. Then we're going to add in witch hazel extract. Now witch hazel extract is really going to help with the toning aspect of the micellar water, really helping to aid in the anti-inflammatory properties that you may need for your skincare product. It's also going to help with any dark under eye issues that you may have. So it really helps to brighten up your skin and really helps to make your skin look a lot more bright. So this is a really great micellar water to use at night before bed, and then when you wake up your skin looks a lot more rejuvenated and fresh. So adding in these two extracts really help to bring this micellar water really up to par and really help to make it not just a micellar water to cleanse your face, but actually have properties that help to elevate your skin as well. Now, when it comes to this micellar water, it really does help to cleanse your skin. I found that when I just put makeup on my arm and use that to cleanse my skin, all of that makeup did come off of my arm, and you're not going to be able to see any additional sparkle on my arm. So it really did help to remove those impurities off of my skin. I didn't notice any dryness or too much dryness. I feel like the glycerin really does help to draw in that moisture that you're going to need. And then you can use this and then put on a serum, or use this and then put on your cream to really help lock in that moisture and keep those additives going in your skin as well. So this is a really great micellar water and a really great place to start when you're trying to add in other additives to see how this can help with your skin overall. Now, if you're interested in any other additives that will help to boost up any of your skincare products, watch this video here where I will share 6 additives to really help beef up your skincare products. And I even have a bonus in there that you're not going to expect, and I'll catch you in the next one.